And of course, we're just talking about the heat back here at home when it comes to the weather.
Wow.
Yeah.
Big time.
Hot and dry.
Unbelievable. I mean, and here's the thing. Now that we've dried out, Anita, these temperatures are going to be able to climb. It was the rain early in the spring and into early summer that actually kept the temperatures around 100. But now you're looking at what's going to probably be a really hot end of July. It could easily carry into August as well. Mm-hmm. Let's take a look for the KOCO cam. Despite the fact there's a few clouds outside, they just spiked up to 109. Before the 5 o'clock news, they were 107. So they actually have gotten warmer in just the last half hour. They've come back down to 106. Love to see some rain come out of some of these clouds. I'm not sure that's going to happen, unfortunately, around the metro. Across the state, pretty much everyone got above 100 today. 109 in Enid. And again, same thing for Oklahoma City for the high, 107 currently. Clinton has actually cooled down to 99 with a couple of thunderstorms in the area. And Ada by far is the coolest at 86 with the showers and storms earlier in Pontotoc County. Officially, Kingfisher is probably going to be the warm spot in the state at 110. Blanchard, not an official site, at 111. Right now, War Acres, you're in at 110. Midwest City, 105. The bottom line is this is dangerous heat that's outside, and this will be carrying in as we head towards the weekend. I told you about the drought. It's only gotten worse, and it's probably only going to get worse, at least for the next couple of weeks. Last week, the percent of the state that was in a severe drought or greater was 38%. This week, we're up to 64%, and that number will probably climb with not a lot of rain in the forecast, at least for most of us over the next 7 days. On Advantage Doppler 3D, the reason why across the metro we had the warmest temperatures in the state is because there was a little boundary just south that kind of snuck up towards Clinton, and just north of that, I think there was a bit of compressional heating that got us a couple of degrees warmer. Earlier in the afternoon, some pretty good storms up at Ada. Now, they didn't get a lot of rain, less than a tenth of an inch, but there were a couple of mesonet sites that had winds over 50 miles an hour, and that's what you get. You get these heat burst winds when you're talking about temperatures of 105 or higher, and you know, there could be some wind and not a lot of rain, unfortunately, with some of these storms. These are pretty much vaporized as they've headed towards I-35 down in south central Oklahoma. And there's the little shower near Clinton, which has dropped the temperature down there. There is some light rain in Cheyenne over towards Elk City, maybe a little bit of lightning developing with one, but that's few and far between. Those storms aren't organized for the most part. If they do, the winds will be the main threat, up to around 50, 55 miles an hour. The chance of rain will be west central to south central Oklahoma. But again, in this area, things will be isolated through the evening and the overnight hours. Lows tonight will be falling back down mainly only in the mid-70s, so you don't get a lot of relief even in the morning hours, and that's one reason why the Weather Service has the heat advisory in effect for the entire state through the weekend. Highs tomorrow will be 105 to 110, and again, it will be remaining warm. 76 will be the morning low, 79 at 8 a.m., already sizzling at noon at 99, with a temperature of 106. Near record heat tomorrow, the record high is 107, and those highs on Saturday, expect 105 to 110 statewide. Please try and stay indoors in the afternoon hours if you can. It's just going to be brutal outside. Again, we'll get close to the record high tomorrow. We'll get close to the record high on Sunday, again, at 105. We'll cool off a little bit if you want to talk about 101 being cooler with a bit of a breeze on Monday. The good news is the ridge relaxes. That should allow temperatures to fall, but I just don't see a real good chance of rain over the next 7 days. And you're up to date with the latest First Alert Forecast.